OCA, Asian Pacific American Advocates, is a national nonprofit organization dedicated to advancing the social, political, and economic well-being of Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders. Based in Washington, D.C., with over 50 chapters around the country, we engage in issues like immigration, education, and fair treatment, among many others. We also provide resources and programs in order to build a pipeline of AAPI leaders so that our community can have a seat at every table.
Hello, everyone. This is H.C. Chang from OCA Greater Houston, all the way from the South, where it is still warm, even during the new year. I want to wish everybody a happy new year of the ox. 新年快乐，恭喜发财。 祝大家牛年扭转乾坤。 Thank you.
Hi, I'm Lisa with the San Francisco chapter, and I thank you so much for coming to our celebrations. I hope you enjoy the Lunar New Year celebration. Chúc mừng năm mới.
Hi, I'm Jess, and I'm with OCA East Bay, Oakland, and we hope you enjoy this Lunar New Year celebration. 恭喜发财, Happy New Year.
My name is Jennifer Kaminsky, and I'm the president of OCA San Mateo. We hope you enjoy this Lunar New Year celebration and wish you a very Happy New Year.
Hi everyone, I'm Kristen Santero with OCA Las Vegas, and we're excited to be coming together with all of our wonderful chapters and to be celebrating Lunar New Year with you and your loved ones. Happy New Year.
I'm Debbie Chen with OCA Greater Houston, and I thank everybody for joining us for these days of Lunar New Year celebration, and we wish you a meaningful and purposeful New Year. Happy Lunar New Year.
Hi, I'm Lisa Wong, president of the OCA Greater Cleveland chapter. Thank you for joining us for this Lunar New Year special. Happy Year of the Ox.
Happy Lunar New Year.
Hey y'all, it's Keisha. OAC Greater Houston and I are going to be collaborating on this year's Lunar New Year. We're talking tarot, covering karma, and all things spiritual. If you want to book a session, check out our Eventbrite page from February 12th to February 27th. I'll see you there.
For the remainder of 2020, OCA Greater Houston's citizenship forums will be virtual. Please help us facilitate the process by filling out your application on Citizenship Works platform. Go online to citizenshipworks.org/portal/Houston and make sure to fill out all the information possible. If you have any questions, please email erica.chambers@ocahouston.org. or call 281-968-9131 for the next steps. Make sure to fill out your application so you can join us online for the virtual visit.
Hi, thank you everyone for joining us. We're very fortunate today to have Master Chef Yin here with us, who's going to demonstrate how to make Shanghai soup dumplings and traditional cabbage and meat dumplings.
Hi, 你好.
谢谢你今天来。欢迎大家收看。 So normally, the dough, you use flour and water with a 2-to-1 ratio.
面粉是2，水是1。
Two parts flour, one part water. 这个水是用冷的还是温的?
温水。
You use warm water.
也可以用秤称一下，这样子比较准一点。
If you want to be really technical and accurate, you can also weigh everything, can measure it.
可是大部分一般在家庭做的话，就是靠手感嘛，然后你看就可以看得出来。因为这样子你会一会儿就是说水会多，一会儿面粉会多。与其这样，你还不如就是说称了来做，比如说称500克面粉，然后再放250克水，然后多那么一点点，只能多一点点。
So Chef Yin says that, you know, typically if you just kind of do it by watching it or looking at it, then you may have like a little bit too much water here or too much flour at a time. So actually the best way is to pre-weigh and measure it out, right? So if you have, you know, exactly 2 parts flour to 1 part water. So he's saying like, you know, 500 milligrams of flour to 250 milligrams of water. Then if you're just off by a little bit, it's not going to be as big of a deal.
一般做饺子呢，面粉要硬一点，就是粉团要硬一点。
Normally, if you're making dumplings, you actually want the dough to be a little firmer.
也有放一点盐来增加劲道的。
Sometimes you can add a little bit of salt, and that increases the firmness as well.
在这里面把它弄干净以后，就放到案板上来揉了。So
once you've gotten most of the flour and dough stuck together and pretty much cleared out the bowl, it's reached a certain firmness, then you can take it out of the bowl and start putting it onto your hard surface to knead directly.
所谓的醒，就是说放着，就让它放着，就叫醒。
So after you knead it for a little bit, then you will set it aside to let it wake up, literally xing, to wake up for about 10 minutes, basically letting it rest, and then after 10 minutes, you take it out and knead it again.
这样子呢，就最好找一块布，把它搭一下。然后呢，我们下面就是做一点有颜色的面团。
Okay, so we're going to actually make some dough with some more color into it, very naturally and organically. This is spinach juice, 菠菜, right?
对，这是菠菜籽。对，然后就少一点，只是上上色而已。
You're putting it in there to just give it color. It's all made from organic spinach juice.
这个揉法和那个前面的面团一样。
You knead it the same way as the other dough. 这样子弄得很漂亮，还不但是漂亮，然后
还比较营养一点。
对，这只能说，增加一点，因为我们餐饮啊，它是色香味形，这个颜色呢是在第一位的。好，先不管它。好，这个就算揉好了。
OK。好。
揉好了。这个马上在做的过程当中再去改变。这面粉拍不拍的没什么。要用同样的办法，这是胡萝卜汁。
Okay, so now this is with carrot juice. 嗯。这刚才打的时候是一根胡萝卜 ，it was like one thick carrot to make this. It was like a chopped into pieces, put into a blender, and then added about 1 cup of water, and blended it, and then we just strained all the fiber out. And we did the same thing with the spinach.It was about 1 bunch of spinach with 1 cup of water.
This color also has many kinds of colors you can think about. So, put chilies, it's more
dark. You can also add sesame if you wanted to have a darker color. You can make different colors based on what you put
in. You can also put cocoa powder, which is chocolate powder.Oh. 它的颜色就是咖啡色的。
You can make them brown with chocolate. You can use cocoa powder.
这个水呢要分多次放入，不要一下放太多。
So when you add in the water, you want to not do it all at one time. You want to do it in parts.
嗯，因为我们今天没有称，也只是凭感觉。好，也让它醒一下。OK.
好。
拿一块布盖一下。
So now we're going to make a meat filling, and it is going to be a ground pork and Napa cabbage meat filling. So this is 1 pound of ground pork.
嗯，然后这里面呢要放姜末。
This is ground up ginger.
对，姜末。然后
盐。
这个是盐。
Salt.
一般正常情况下是1磅猪肉5克盐。五克，
我还真的不晓得英文怎么翻译。
5g.
Oh, 5 grams. It's like 1 pound of meat to 5 grams salt. Which, looking at that, is about a little bit more than half a teaspoon.
因为我们要放白菜，所以盐呢就多放一点。
Because we're going to use Napa cabbage, so he's going to put a little more salt.So with that, I would estimate that to be closer to 1 teaspoon.
这是鸡精。
This is chicken bouillon. 嗯，
一般也是放个4-5克左右。有人不喜欢就别放。
It's really to personal taste. If you like it, you add it. If you don't, you don't. This is sugar.
因为动物脂肪呢，它是带一点点酸性的。动物肉，它带一点点酸性。我们要放一点糖下去，把它。
So you add a little bit of sugar, and it, in combination, it gets rid of the fleshy smell and taste of meat.
然后少放一点酱油。
A little bit of soy sauce.
Okay. 先把它捏均匀。
First, mix it evenly. 没关系。
然后呢，一磅那个猪肉啊，要放100克水。
About 100 grams of water. 所以放水进去是让它比较松。
对，让它嫩，让它
To make it more tender, make it soft. That's the purpose of adding in water.
顺着一个方向。
And then you mix it in one direction.
顺着一个方向。
为什么要顺着一个方向？
顺着一个方向呢？它就是说，让它的那个经络啊会顺，不然你这样来回倒，它那个吸水量就是不怎么会充分。
So it impacts when you, the reason why you stir in one direction is because it impacts the fibers and how it absorbs the water, absorbs the ingredients.
如果是做纯肉的呢，150克水要放足的。
If you're doing pure meat and no vegetables in it, then you would add 150 grams of water.
因为我们今天有白菜，白菜里面有水分。
But because we're putting in Napa cabbage and the cabbage itself has water content, that's why you don't need as much water added in.
所以水就没有放到150克，大概100克左右。好了，等到这个拌均匀了，
so after it's
上劲了，然后我们把素菜放下去。
After it's mixed evenly, now you put in your vegetables. And so this is pre-cut chopped.
白菜末
Napa cabbage.
放一点香菇末。
This is some shiitake mushrooms.
然后葱花多一点。
Some green scallions, onions.
北方用的是他们的那种，中国的北方，用的是那种大胡葱。它比这个我们这个葱香。
He says in the north, northern China style, you would use a different type of green onion. It's like a really thick.Large ones that has a more pungent flavor.
因为这个肉啊，它里面的脂肪不是很多，所以我们要放一点油下去。放一点那个芝麻油，或者说色拉油都行。
So to add to it, we would put a little bit of sesame oil or cooking oil. Sesame oil makes it more fragrant.So now we're using pure sesame oil. You can use just cooking oil, but pure sesame oil has an added fragrance to it. That was about 2 tablespoons worth. Honestly, a large part of this is to taste.
Also, put a little egg, but.
Some people put an egg in there.
这个就是根据个人喜欢了。
It's really to personal preference. 其实像现在很多人说，哦，过年要吃饺子，那是一个北方的custom. 像南部不是说过年要吃饺子。
对，以前是这样，但是现在随着信息啊人员的流动量增大以后了呢，它那个文化在相互的那个渗透
都在改变。
对
对，
你接受我的，我接受你的，这样子。
So we were saying, you know, traditionally in the north of China you would have dumplings, but you wouldn't necessarily have dumplings in the south for Lunar New Year. And you know, now in modern times with peopleHaving the convenience of being able to move around a lot more, a lot of the different traditions and customs are actually being mixed. So it's not as split between, you know, northerners eat this or southerners eat this. You know, a lot of people are eating all things. 所以说我爸是跟我讲说，小的时候中国以前很穷嘛，不是说天天都可以吃到肉的，对不对？
对对
对。就是平常一般大部分还是吃素的。那就是过年的时候你会有机会多一点肉，所以就说吃肉包的饺子，或者像南部的你可能会吃蹄膀啊，或者是火锅啊。
对对，是的。
So, you know, saying how my dad told me, you know, China used to be very poor, right? The average person, you didn't eat meat all the time. 像我外婆就说现在就是几乎是像天天都在过年，天天都可以吃肉。So now, right, it's much more prosperous.And it's much more convenient. Yeah. So before you would eat dumplings because it was during the New Year, it was your opportunity to eat meat, right? to have meat in larger quantities or to have like, you know, roast tipong or, you know, to have hot pot. Whereas now it's, my grandmother used to say, like, now it's almost like it's New Year's every day because you can just go and buy meat conveniently in the supermarket. It's just very easy.
然后把它放进冰箱。
Okay, now we would put this in the refrigerator to let it cool off and solidify a little more. So this is the dough that we made before and we let it sit and rest for a bit. So now you come out and you knead it some more. So that it's more even. It'll have this more smooth sheen to it.
好了。 OK. 然后可以开始做，下面就开始第一个做小笼包吧。小笼包。所以做小笼包的馅，就是这个面是跟做饺子的面一样的。对，可以。小笼包以前呢，每个地区它有不同。
So you can use the same dough to make soup dumplings that you use for regular dumplings. But every, you know, area will have their own slight unique differences.
这个干面粉呢，放在边上是防止做的时候面团粘连的。
So to have a little bit of extra dry flour on the side so that you're preventing the dough from sticking.
好，我们下面下剂。面团呢，它分几种，就是分几个步骤。下剂，然后在这个叫搓条，这个要练。今天呢，我就大概示范一下，你们照着这个去练。小笼包。
So this takes practice.
小笼包的胚子呢是八克。
So for soup dumplings, each one, it's about 8 grams, each piece. So he's basically saying this takes practice, right?
一般只要不少于8克，不大于10克都行。
So you don't want to have it below 8 grams and over 10 grams. So as long as it's between 8 and 10, then you're good.
然后呢，把它按扁，按扁一定要把这个断口朝上。So
there's a specific technique. You have to have it flattened from the top down. The sides where you broke it open. So it's like the open ends.
因为这样擀出来皮子是圆的。That
way it comes out, it'll be round.
如果是这个横截面按下去，If
you did it from the side, it won't be as round.
那个擀出来皮子是方的，不好擀。It'll
actually come out more squarish and be very difficult.
擀皮子呢，我也来示范一下。擀皮子呢，一个手推，一个手转。So
one hand is pushing, the other hand is turning.
推一下，转一下，推一下，这个推。Press
forward and then you turn it.
对，这个手转。One
press, one turn.
对，一个手推，一个手转，然后往上推，用力，往下来不要用力。So
when you're doing it, right, the hand that's moving forward, you're pressing down, and then as you roll back, you're releasing. So you're not putting any pressure on as you roll back. The pressure is only on the front side.
对，这个呢要多做。And
really, you just have to do it a lot.
如果说
The more you do it, the better you're going to get. 就多做就越来越好，越来越熟悉。可以到很快，但是上来不能快，上来只能先慢一点。But when you're first starting, you really, it's okay. Go slow. You don't have to be super fast.
我再擀一个慢一点的。No.
Do it slower so you can see.
一般一个皮子擀6到7下。
Normally, one skin you roll 6 to 8 times.
往上推用劲，下来不要用力啊。
Yeah. And just be sure that when you're going forward, you're using pressure forward, and when you go backwards, you're releasing the pressure.
每一次只感到这个皮子的一半不到。
And each time you go up, you're not going over halfway, like just under, just shy of halfway up this.
这个皮子小的时候，它也是一半。
Even when it's smaller, you still only do up to a half.
但它现在大了，也是一半。那反正是它现有的一半。OK。好，小笼包馅。这个小笼包的馅呢，制作是比较复杂的。
This is the soup dumpling filling, so it's a little more complicated to make.
它主要是它的里面啊，因为汁多，为什么会多？因为它有皮冻。
So because soup dumplings, there's essentially the soup part, right? But that soup is essentially the skin that becomes gelatinous, that melts so when you cook it, right? So right now it's like a jelly.
这个皮冻呢，制作需要一个很长的时间，大概要四五个小时吧。
Takes about 4 to 5 hours just to prepare the jelly part, which is made from a pork skin.
这里只能做一个大概的介绍。怎样来制作这个皮冻？这个皮冻呢，需要肉皮。然后。把它初步加工，把它上面多余的油脂要去掉，然后经过搓水清洗，
So it's multiple steps, right? First, you're going to make sure it's all clean, the skin is completely cleaned, and then you're going to get rid of the excess fat off of the skin, so that you're just left with the skin.
然后要经过熬制，
Then you cook it literally.Boil it for 几个小时
两个小时左右
Minimum 2 hours
两个小时当中还有一个比例问题就是水和这个肉皮的比例因为这是一个需要长时间去学习和掌握的一个技巧
And then, you know, what's really important is the ratio of the water to the skin.And that just comes with experience.
所以在这里呢，我们只能给大家看一个现成的。
So for today's purpose, we just already pre-made the filling with the gelatin from pork skin.
这个皮冻呢是打碎的，这里有、这个。
You can see like the little bits because after it's cooked, right? Then it's cooled and then it's chopped.Finally, into little bits before it's mixed in with the pork, ground pork, to make this filling. So, 这样子就均匀，你包出来、蒸出来的时候，就不是说这里一颗颗一把一个洞一个洞 ，right? 它是均匀的。
对。
So this way, it's mixed in evenly. So when you cook the soup dumpling, it melts evenly also.
小笼包呢还有口味的区别，在大陆有上海小笼包。
And soup dumplings, there are different types of soup dumplings based on where you are. The most commonly known is Shanghai style soup dumplings.
还有在中国比较出名的有一个叫无锡小笼包。
Oh, and a place called 无锡, they're known for their 小笼包 as well.
它以口味偏甜为主。
Theirs tend to be a little on the sweet side.
也很受人们的喜欢的。好了。这个馅就介绍到这里，
好，
我们现在开始制作。反正也不能太少，大概在总共连皮子和馅在25克左右。
So total, right, with the skin and the meat together, is around 25 grams.
小笼包能够进美国，要感谢鼎泰丰。
Everyone knows about soup dumplings because of a famous Taiwan restaurant called Ding Tai Fung, so everyone knows about it. Right, but there's different styles. So Ding Tai Fung, Ding Tai Fung style is when they wrap it, they seal them completely. Whereas a lot of places in China actually do not seal the top.
现在基本上市面做，就是在美国能看到小笼包，大多以鼎泰丰的小笼包为标准。
So everyone uses Ding Tai Fung soup dumplings as a standard to measure by.
在中国大陆的小笼包比这个大。
But in China, the soup dumplings are usually made a little larger.
在中国大陆的小笼包呢是不收口的，它上面有个嘴。
Yeah, in China, they don't close it off like in Taiwan. It's open.
一个小笼包上面应该不得少于18个褶。
You're supposed to have 18 folds per dumpling. Each time, you're gonna lift, then pinch, and stuff.
然后可以做得很快，然后如果说做得熟练了就是很快，也可以把口捏，这个做完结束。好，谢谢。然后做饺子了。好，谢谢。下面我们开始做饺子。Okay,
we're going to start making dumplings, just regular dumplings.
饺子呢，在北方是一个很受欢迎的，现在南方人也开始接受了。
Dumplings are very, very popular in northern China, and now the people from the south are starting to appreciate it as well.
其实它的造型呢就一种，它变的就是它的馅。
It's pretty much just one standard shape, and what changes is the filling.
但是到了南方以后呢，南方的不叫水饺，叫蒸饺。
Oh, so once it started coming into the southern China's areas, they stopped calling it just regular dumplings. They called it 蒸饺 instead of 水饺. So it's like instead of boiled dumplings, you would steam it.
真的去蒸出来的。对，这个意思是什么？是水饺，哪里就是南方也有，但是南方多了一个蒸饺。多了蒸饺的目的是为了多出造型，因为煮的饺子。 它形状永远是那个只有一个形状，因为你要做出其他造型出来，在水里煮是会破坏掉的。
I see. So what he said is once it got to the south, they essentially innovated, right? And so instead of only being limited to dumplings that you would boil and with that one standard shape, then in the south you could make it into different shapes and they would steam them. Because by steaming it, it would hold its shape. Whereas if you boil it, it doesn't hold its shape.
下面我们先做几个传统的水饺。
So first we're going to start off with making some very traditional style dumplings.
水饺一般它的剂子在10克左右。
For a dumpling, generally speaking, one piece is about 10 grams is your goal. 所以比小笼包稍微多一点点。对，大一点。So just a little bit more dough than a soup dumpling. A soup dumpling, we're targeting at 8 grams, and for a regular dumpling, you're targeting a 10 gram piece of dough.
我只做8个。好。这个擀皮子也是一样，也是要把这个断口朝上。Same
thing. You put the ends top bottom so that if you press down, it becomes round. If you do it the other way, it won't come out as round. It makes it harder when you're actually rolling it into the pieces.
每个人的包法都不同。
Everyone wraps it slightly differently.
但是有个前提，就是说不能破。
With certain fixed guidelines, right? You don't want the skin to break.
对，这个拿皮子啊，是这样拿，这边窝着，要让它形成一个下凹的，像个小碗一样的。
So there's a technique to it, right? When you're wrapping it, you want to put the skin so it's almost like in a little cup, like cup your hand in the finger area so that it becomes almost like a little mini bowl.
一个水饺大概也是在25克左右。
So your goal is to also total skin and filling together around 25 grams.
馅尽量多一点，尽量多。
So you want to put more filling in if you can.
但不能太多，太多你包不上。
But just not too much to the point where you can't wrap it.
然后包的时候这样捏一下。
You're gonna pinch it in the middle.
然后用这个虎口夹住。
And then you pinch the sides.
这边拐弯，这边按下去，这边也按下去，然后。形成一个三角形。
To make it into like a triangle.
往当中稍微挤一下，这两边用力。
You pinch it really hard on the sides.
然后一个水饺就包好。好，这样捏一下，这样子。挤的时候呢，是主要把这个封口。
Your main goal is to seal it on the sides.
把这个封口按紧。
Press really hard. Seal it.
这样子按紧，这样就好了。然后有一点肚子。南方呢，为什么叫蒸饺？像这样的饺。
But in the South, you would do it differently, right?
南方的饺子是蒸的。
In the South, you would do it differently because traditionally you would actually steam it. You're not boiling it.
对。蒸的饺子呢，它。造型就多，我们
So you can make different prettier designs.
它是有褶的。
对，我小时候就是这样子，where you would pinch and fold on each side. I was saying this is how I had to do it when I was a child. So that you would have this pretty design.
它就是会有一个褶的形状。
Yep. See, and then when you steam it, it would hold its shape. So if you're going to steam it, then typically instead of just 10 grams of dough, you would want to try and have 2 extra grams of 12 grams of dough. So it's just slightly more. We're just doing it as an example so everyone can see. Just a sample for everyone to see. In Fujian province,
有一种蒸饺
There's a type of steamed dumpling.
现在在中国到处很多地方都有卖
That's really popular in China right now.
它是做成秋叶形状，我现在做给大家看。
Oh, so it's 从两边这样子捏。
对。
So it's being pinched and folded from both sides. This is a Fujian style. Oh.Yeah.
它是这样子的。再包一个。
So you pinch one side at a time.
一边一下。如果这个线可以拿手按一下去一点。
我在
我们做那个现在比较流行的彩色水饺。
OK。
所谓的彩色水饺就是皮子是彩色的。
OK。So he's just going to make a sample of what's currently popular of making colored dumplings.
其实也不是很复杂，只要知道怎么做就行。第一个呢，把这个白的。这个放着，然后把这个 擀一下。差不多长，把它裹进去。
哦。哦，这弄出来会很漂亮。嗯，
我把这多余的要切掉。
OK。So you want to wrap it, but you want to cut off the excess. So you want to have just enough to wrap it.
Okay. Okay. Then put it together.一定要包严的，然后就跟前面一样搓条。
OK。Roll it out evenly. 嗯。
然后是下剂。
差不多几克？
这个，如果你包水饺，
嗯，
就是十克，
嗯，
如果你要做蒸饺就大一点，
嗯，
我们包两个水饺吧。
好，
包两个水饺。
So for water cooked dumplings, about 10 grams.
然后我们做几个蒸饺。
For steamed dumplings,、
嗯、
make it a little larger, so 大概十二克。
对，十二克。
About 12 grams.
就多包几个吧。
嗯，
然后。水饺也多几个吧，水饺包五个。
So the right side is for water cooked dumplings, the left side is for steamed dumplings.
包五个吧 ，OK。好，这个是肯定要。
Now、this you must be sure to like top down.
因为你只有这样子才能看到它的颜色。
Otherwise, you're not going to be able to see the color differences.
这个呢？也有人拿下剂，不会像拿刀切的，也是这也是可以。我能感觉到大小。
He's saying how it's mixed together, but he can tell the difference when he's touching it, you know, which is the larger and which is the smaller. For those of us who are amateurs and doing this at home, strongly suggested that you keep them separated into separate piles. So first he's going to wrap water dumplings.
这个只是一个颜色，其他没什么。就是一个颜色，一定要按一下，然后这样捏住，我就慢一点。
So you're pressing it hard on the sides to seal it, and then pressing outwards so that the meat kind of bulges out, so it's got like a little belly on each side. So 两边都有一个小肚子。
对。这样子呢，它有一边，反正两边都一样。你的嘴巴有点。 我们下面做一下南方的那个。So
now we're gonna make southern style steamed dumplings.
花色蒸饺，这个绿色呢正好。Colored
steamed dumplings.
白菜色。So
this green color is almost like Napa cabbage. Like these kind are really more for, it has a more of a decorative, I guess, decorative feeling to it, right? The taste, you know, the texture is going to all be the same, but it gives you so many more options of making it look pretty or different presentation styles. So it's just, like you said, it just makes it look nicer. But it's the same dough, it's the same filling. Oh, I can look like a flower on. So he's folding it by just pinching it and turning it into little leaves. So now it looks like. So this style is actually called a cabbage dumpling because it's made to look like a little bunch of cabbage. So the other one was four folds, and now he wants to do a five leaf fold. So this is very fancy. Like if you were in China, you would really only see this in like large hotels or, you know, large restaurants, right? It's not something you'd see on the average street corner store because it takes so much time to make. He says in America, labor is so much more expensive. There's really nobody who's doing this. Yeah, really, I highly doubt anybody even really knows how to make it. Yeah, like there is no restaurant in Houston that does this. Houston 现在没有一家餐馆在做这个，没人做，没有人做，很麻烦就没人做。 Yeah, it takes time. It takes a certain skill level to be able to make this.
线太软，定型不好定。
So because we're doing this right here, we didn't put the filling into the refrigerator to chill it. So it's harder to form the shape because the filling is so soft. So typically, if you're going to do this, the filling needs to be a little firmer after you've refrigerated it.
有一种饺叫四喜饺，它是可以分成
a four happiness dumpling. It's the literal translation. So you can only steam this one because it's got open.
这个饺子是不可能放水里煮的。You
cannot possibly put this into water boil, it will just fall apart. So this is only for steaming. It's the four happiness dumpling.
这个叫四喜蒸饺。Four
happiness steamed dumpling.
有时候呢，四喜蒸饺。对，这里面。 它有四个洞，然后可以放一点香菇末，鸡蛋。You
have four pockets.
香菇末，鸡蛋。You
could put little things. You put minced carrots, minced shiitake mushrooms, minced tofu.
它就这个样子。
So this is another style, where it's a two pocket. 这也是一个很传统的.
对, 这个叫,
it's also a very traditional style.
这个叫蒸饺. 这上面可以放一个虾仁.
You put one shrimp.
也可以放一点鸡蛋, 炒熟的鸡蛋.
Or some stir-fried egg.
对, 这个叫两千角.
It has two pockets. So now we're going to make some dumplings with the other dough that we had made, which is from carrot juice. So it has a pretty light orange pastel color to it. Okay, so we're also going to make some water dumplings and then some steamed dumplings. So it doesn't use the tip because it's not even. It's such a pretty color. We're going to first wrap some water cooked dumplings.
蒸饺.
Okay, we're going to do a steamed dumpling.
这个饺叫灌顶饺.
灌顶饺.
灌顶, 就是像个帽子一样的.
Oh, so it's a hat.
古人戴的帽子.
灌顶. So like a traditional scholar's hat.
不是现在人戴的.
Actually, technically an official's hat.
这个饺子就是馅少, 一般放那个甜馅多一点.
So you use less filling, and typically people would use like a sweet filling. So you can use 像用红豆沙, 是不是?
对,
like red bean paste or green bean paste, 绿豆沙.
因为它的馅少, 所以它要重口味的馅.
So there's less filling, so you would want to have like a strong taste filling. 哦,这个很漂亮. 所以这就变成像一个甜点一样.
对,它也算是一个水饺一类吧.
It's a type of dumpling, but almost like a dessert, even.
蒸饺.
But it's a steamed type of dumpling. So, 先捏好,然后再捏花进去. So you first pinch it sealed, and then you would pinch the ruffle into it. Wow, and then you would still flip the edge over. 哇,这好漂亮. Yeah, there's definitely no restaurant that's doing this. 这个真的就是没有一个餐馆会在这边做这个。这真的还真的只有那种大饭店才会去做。对，小餐馆不会做的。 Yeah, none of the small restaurant places are going to make this because the labor cost would be too high. You're only going to see this in like a big restaurant, like a hotel.
不然它太孤独。
He's going to make two so the other one's not lonely.
这个饺子呢，就是观赏性大于它的实用性。
So this is really for looks and not for practicality. 这样子一个一个小的，一口就吃光了。Like literally, these are like bite size. One bite and it's gone.
其实吃真不如水饺。它只是，但是它功夫很大。
对。
它要花很长时间去。
I mean, when you eat it, it's really not as satisfying as just eating regular dumplings that are just, you know, boiled in water, right? But the presentation is just a totally different feel to have southern-styled steamed dumplings. Okay, we're gonna make a couple more simple ones. So this is literally just folded in half, and we're just, oh. So we sealed it, and now we're making a ruffle along the edge. 太软了哈。So the filling's too soft, is what he's saying. Oh, 这个也很漂亮。
像机关一样。
Yeah, this is a simpler one that it's probably easier for anyone to try at home. Right? Because it's literally, after you've flattened it and rolled it out, you just fold it in half and seal the edge so it becomes like a half moon. And then you see how he's just slowly pinching it to make a ruffle.And then what he's doing is he's pinching the base at the edge of the ruffle to have it hold together. How 漂亮
就这样这就是观赏性的增加
This is really for presentation. 林师傅谢谢你今天来教我们怎么做。我看一般的人在美国从来没看过这些做出来的这样子的花样
只是他们会没有时间做罢了我只是也偶尔做做平时也不是做也不会去做的
对可是这就是说我们在美国就 很少有机会去见识到这样子的因为一般的餐馆不会做这样子的花样只有说你自己在家庭可以做因为这个花的时间比较多
对其实做东西呢餐饮没有什么就是多学多练现在很多网上包括那个叫 YouTube 抖音叫 TikTok 上面都有很多人做得很好的
对
也都在教大家做
对So I was saying to Chef Yin you know, thank you so much because for coming and showing us this today becauseIn America, you really wouldn't have the opportunity to go to a restaurant to see these different type of decorative styles simply because it'd be cost prohibitive for any restaurant to do it, right? Even in China, you're really looking at going to a large hotel restaurant or a large fancy restaurant would you see something like this. But for those of us to make it at home, right, just to for our own family and friends, then it's something that you can possibly do.And, you know, as Chef Yin was saying that now there are a lot of people who do videos, short videos on YouTube or TikTok so that, you know, these traditional art forms and crafts can be spread and learned by many people. So, 谢谢你今天来 Thank you so
谢谢
much.
好拜拜
So here we have our final finished products. These are traditional steamed dumplings from southern China style.And so you can see there are different pretty patterns, right? And when you steam them, steam for about 8 minutes, okay? And then on my left hand over here, these are traditional, I'm gonna call it water dumplings because it's a literal translation, but essentially dumplings that you boil in water. And these also you boil for 8 minutes. And then back here,
is the soup dumplings, Shanghai-styled soup dumplings that we made earlier. Because we made them fresh, with fresh filling, you would steam these for only 5 minutes.